Good evening, and welcome to Woodland Bible Church's Christmas Eve service. May I just begin by saying Merry Christmas to all of you. I'm so glad that you're here with us tonight as we worship the Lord's birth together. Tonight, being our annual Christmas Eve service, we're going to be doing what we normally do, and it's kind of become a tradition here at Woodland Bible Church, to celebrate the Lord's birth on Christmas Eve by lighting the Advent Advent candles. So we're going to be lighting the candles behind me as we go through the service. Hopefully you picked up a program as you walked in, and also a candle, which we'll be using at the end of our service tonight. But along the way, we're going to be singing some carols together. We're going to be listening to some scripture passages read about our Lord's birth, listening to some special music, celebrating communion together, and just worshiping in a spirit of worship tonight as we celebrate our Lord's birth. So sit back, enjoy, participate, and we're going to have a great time this evening. At this time, I'd like to invite Dan, I believe, is going to be leading us in our congregational hymns.
Let's stand and sing. Oh, holy night.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear.
Yeah.
We light the first candle, the candle of prophecy, which represents hope. The hope that God gave us through the promised Messiah, our Savior. Jesus is the hope that we can have eternal life.
Isaiah 7:14. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Isaiah 9:6-7. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there will be no end. Upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to order it and establish it with judgment and justice from that time forward, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this.
Let's continue our singing. O come, Emmanuel.
Come thou day spring.
We light the second candle of Advent, the candle of preparation. Represents faith. Reminds us of the faith that Mary and Joseph had as they waited and prepared for our Savior's birth.
Now the birth of Jesus was as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take you, Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins.
So all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child, bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which translates God with us. Then Joseph, being aroused from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took his wife, and did not know her till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus.
His mercy extends to those who fear him.
Let's stand and sing, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
O little town of Bethlehem, how still.
seated.
Light the third candle, the candle of promise. It represents the joy that the shepherds experienced when they heard the announcement from the angels that a child was being born. And this promise was not just for the shepherds, but for all those who would accept him.
Okay, I'm reading tonight from Luke. Chapter 2, verses 8 through 12. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you in this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger."
Please join us and stand and sing, "What a Glorious Night."
Shepherds came to see the baby, stood by his mother's side. Here lay the Savior inside a manger. Oh, what a glorious night! Oh, what a glorious night! I hear the angels singing, Alleluia, let the earth receive her King. Jesus Christ is born. Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds wondered, they couldn't hide it. Told everyone inside. All were amazed when they heard how God came down on that glorious night.
God came down
on that glorious night. Hear the angels singing, Hallelujah, let the earth receive her King. I know that love has come, sing it out, Jesus Christ is born. Jesus Christ is born.
This is the time in our service where we specifically let the children get in on what we're doing in this evening. And so my wife has a children's story that she'd like to read. If any of the kids would like to come forward and just sit up here on the floor and listen to the children's story, then I invite you to come forward at this time. Or if you feel like you need the social distance, you can stay back there. The pictures from the storybook will be on the overhead behind me, so you can watch and follow along as she reads.
All right, is everybody ready? Are you all settled? Can you see up there? Can you see the pictures? Okay, I'm going to read you the story, and you look up there for the pictures, okay? This is called Humphrey's First Christmas, written and illustrated by Carol Hayer. Beloved, most beauteous, and exalted King of all, should be my name. Instead, they call me Humphrey. This I could bear if the worst thing of all had not happened. My dearest possession, my glorious carpet blanket, has been lost along the trail. Now I am never warm, and I suffer terribly. That is why I have set into motion a plan to replace my greatest of all treasures. I carefully nudge my nose inside the caravan master's tent. This is followed closely by the chattering of my teeth, thereby letting the master know that I am most enormously cold. Success! He has not pushed me out, and I remain hopeful that a new blanket will soon be mine. Three rich caravans have joined us, and there has been talk of kings. Yet these kings bring me no joy, for they have tied three huge chests to my bare back. They are so heavy, I am sure each must be filled with rocks. Now, look at those chests up there. Do they look huge? You think Humphrey exaggerates a little bit? I think so. The other camels are wearing the finest of blankets. They are all comfortable and warm. Not one of them thinks about me, their cousin, in pain and misery because of the loss of my most precious carpet blanket. I cry out in sorrow. I weep. Today, I continue my plan to regain my treasured blanket. I add loud sniffling to the chattering of teeth and squeeze my entire body inside my master's tent. As I do so, out rolls my master, for the tent is exactly camel-sized. He's kind of squished out there. It is as I planned. As the master chases me away, he tosses me a new blanket. I have success. Once more, I am covered with splendor and comfort. I am filled with delight. If it were not for the heavy chest I am forced to carry, I would be most happy. We have followed one star for many long nights. Now our caravan enters the town of Bethlehem. Its streets and inns are crowded with travelers. My master gives no thought to my tired feet and rumbling belly. I am forced to move on. At last we reach the end of our journey, but I'm confused. There is no great palace, no rich oasis, no palms heavy with fruit. I see only a lowly stable with a family inside. The three kings rejoice and rush forward to bow before the young woman who cradles a baby. Who is that baby? Mm-hmm. Finally, the chests are taken from my back and placed before this tiny child. As each box is opened, I see no stones, only gold, frankincense, and myrrh. In this land, I have walked past many children, but never before have I felt the need to walk toward one. Now, I kneel before this baby, shivering in the manger. Watching him gladdens me more than sweet water, fresh hay, or even my new wondrous blanket. I look into the baby's eyes. and I am overwhelmed with love. I pull the treasure from my back and lay my gift carefully upon this child. What did he give him?
His blanket.
That was his, he worked really hard to get that blanket. He smiles, and my nose and whiskers tingle with joy. I am happy to my toes. And even without my blanket, I feel warm. Who's that?
Baby Jesus.
It is baby Jesus. Behold, most beauteous and exalted King of all should be his name. Instead, they call him Jesus.
You guys did really, really well listening to the story. Would you like to do me a favor and all of your parents a favor? Could you guys help me sing a song? Do you guys know Away in the Manger? So can you turn around and stand up and look towards your parents, and let's all sing Away in the Manger together, okay? Do I have accompaniment?
No, here it goes. Just go. Oh, go ahead.
I got, oh. Away in the manger, no crib for a bed. Thy little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet bed. The stars in the sky look down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep. Didn't they do a great job? One more thing. Would you guys like to have a treat? Here you go. Take a candy cane and go back to your parents, okay? Yes. If there's any kids out there, kids, that would like one of these afterwards, there's some up here. So we light the fourth candle, the candle of proclamation. Reminds us of the message of peace. Peace on the earth that the angels proclaimed. It's a promise that the Prince of Peace will be with us through all of our struggles and enable us to reach out to others with that message of peace.
Luke 2:13-17.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So it was, and when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another,
"Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told to them concerning this child.
Please stand and sing with us, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Joy, joy, and triumph in your grace.
Thank you. May be seated.
Waits for a miracle, the heart longs for a little bit of hope. Oh come, Emmanuel. A child prays for peace on earth, and she's calling out from a sea of hurt. Oh come, Emmanuel. With the tears of a mother, a baby's cry is the sound of love. Come down, Emmanuel.
Light the last candle, the candle of purpose. Represents love. It's also the Christ candle, because Christ is at the center of Christmas. God gave us the greatest gift of all through his love and the giving of us of his Son for the purpose of dying for our sins. So tonight we celebrate that Christ has come.
John chapter 3, verses 16 through 18. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He who believes in him is not condemned, but he who does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God.
We've celebrated tonight the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, but he didn't just come to be born as a baby. He came with the purpose to die. And so tonight we also want to remember his death by participating in what we refer to as the Lord's Communion. Jesus Christ came to die for the sin of all mankind. And we remember that death and that payment that he made for us on our behalf by partaking of the elements in the communion. Two elements that Paul talks about in Corinthians chapter 11 when he was writing to the church there in Corinth. He says, "For this I received from the Lord, which I also deliver to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes.'" So tonight we're going to be partaking of the bread and the juice. The bread, of course, represents the body of Christ that hung on the cross and was crucified for us. And the juice represents the blood of Christ that was shed. The Word of God tells us that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sins. So tonight, as we partake of these elements, each of them in turn, we'll partake of them together. And hopefully you picked up a cup that has both those elements. There's a little cellophane top that you can peel back to get to the bread, and then the other part that peels back gets to the juice. But let me remind us of what Jesus said on the night in which he instituted this with his disciples. In the book of Matthew chapter 26, as they were celebrating the Passover feast, the last Passover feast that Jesus would have with his disciples, it says, as they were eating, Jesus took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." Let's ask the Lord's blessing on the bread as we partake of it tonight together. Father, we thank you and praise you for the privilege that we have to be able to celebrate your birth tonight. And yet, Lord, we know that you didn't stay a baby. You came to this earth for the express purpose of allowing your body to be crucified, hung on a cross, and put to death. So tonight we remember that purpose by partaking of these elements, the bread which represents your body that was given for us on behalf of us and because of our sin. So I pray that you would bless this element as we partake of it and remember that sacrifice that you did for us. For we ask this in Christ's name. Amen. Matthew goes on there in Matthew chapter 26 and says, "Then he took the cup, and he gave thanks, and he gave it to them, saying, 'Drink from it, all of you. For this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. But I say to you, I will not drink from this fruit of the vine from now on until the day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom.'" Let's ask the Lord's blessing on the juice as we partake of it tonight. Heavenly Father, Lord, once again, we pause to just give thanks. Thanks that your Son, the Holy Child of God, without spot and without blemish, allowed himself to be offered up as a perfect sacrifice, the Lamb of God for us, who shed his precious blood for the remission of our sin. Father, tonight as we partake of this juice that represents that blood that was shed, that you instituted with your disciples and passed down from generation to generation to generation, all the way down to us, Lord, we partake of this tonight in remembrance of that sacrifice that you did for us by shedding your blood. And we'll be careful to thank you and praise you for all this we ask in Christ's most precious and holy name. Amen. Okay, we're going to conclude our service tonight by having a candlelight, and we're going to get up from where you're sitting and probably form a circle all the way around the auditorium, all the way up here, and while we're lighting the candles, we're going to sing Silent Night, which is a great Christmas Eve song. And parents, if you have children and they have candles, please watch them. If you don't feel like they should be playing with fire, then I'll leave it to your discretion. Before we turn out the lights, we'll let everybody get in place, and then I will light my candle from the Christ candle, and then we'll proceed the light around the room as we sing Silent Night, Holy Night. Okay, we can have the lights.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yonder.
Father, we just thank you and praise you tonight for the privilege that we've had to celebrate and worship you. Thank you that we have this opportunity, and thank you for all these that have come out tonight to do that, to worship your coming. Lord, I pray that as we leave this place that we would do so with a renewed spirit and excitement and joy of sharing the hope, the peace, the purpose for your coming with all those that we come in contact with. And Lord, we'll be careful to thank you and praise you for all this we ask in our precious Lord and Savior's name. Amen. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
you can just turn my mic back on. You can drop these candles in the box that you picked them up from on your way out. We'd really appreciate that. Thank you. Thank you.